story. Omar Abdullah's biggest crisis has even embroiled his father and Union Minister Farooq Abdullah. Claims made by an eyewitness to what happened at Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister's home on the 29th of September have sent out widespread tremors, denials falling on deaf ears. All of this coming, of course, on a day when the opposition has been mounting a lot of pressure, in fact, on Farooq Abdullah as well as Omar Abdullah to come out and make their position clear in public.
Besides Chief Minister Omar Abdullah, the heat is on his father too. And amid the government's silence to charges, Dr. Abdullah veers and ducks frantically.
The implications are huge. Omar Abdullah's version stands contradicted almost completely. Now, the Chief Minister would have to answer almost everything, ranging from allegations of extortion to the details of the post-mortem report of deceased Shah. And there is no underplaying the threat to his Chief Ministership and the alliance between National Conference and Congress.
CM Saab ne kaha, ji ye jo dusra aadmi hai, isse kitne liya? Bola isse maine 85 lakhs li. Bola isko kab wapas karoge? To isne kaha janab iske liye agar aapse baat karenge. To CM Saab ne bola andar kya karna hai? Aap mujhe yahi bata. Bola agar yahi batana hai, to fir sabse behtar yahi rahega ki Dr. Farooq Abdullah Saab ko aane do.
Anybody can mention anybody's name. How can you stop them? You cannot stop them. They are welcome to say anything. Who stops anybody? I don't stop anybody. This is a democratic country. It is not an autocratic country.
The opposition steps in again, terming Farooq Abdullah's defense little more than hilarious.
A death has taken place, and it has exposed the level of corruption at the highest level. Even last year, the Union government came with a report that in Jammu Kashmir there is trust deficit, there is, you know, governance deficit, and today this incident has exposed the very same thing to the country.
The snowballing Yusuf Shah custodial death fiasco has embroiled an array of faces.
Now take a look at people around the entire custodial death issue who now need to give answers. At the top, the Chief Minister himself, who has to explain all the claims made by eyewitness Salam Rishi. Farooq Abdullah, who allegedly demanded the money for ministerial births, has to give some answers too. The version of Minister of State for Home and Tourism, who was present at the Chief Minister's house when the drama unfolded, will be crucial. IGP Crime Ezad Ali was present there too, and his boss, DGP Kuldeep Hoda, as head of the force, has to explain the eyewitnesses' claims. Then the others present at the Chief Minister's house on the 29th of September, his security officer Shabbir Ahmad, his political advisor Devinder Singh Rana, and the other complainant against Yusuf Shah, Muhammad Yusuf Bhatt.
What actually happened on the 29th of September? How did Yusuf Shah die? The political embarrassments are out for all to see. Definite answers, though, evade us still. With Suhail Bukhari in Srinagar, Bureau Report, NewsX.
All the reports that you've just heard prompt us and leave us asking, in fact, one question. Is it time now for a CBI inquiry, for an independent probe, which could perhaps, at this moment, restore confidence in the entire judicial process? To discuss these questions, we are joined by Professor Bhim Singh, Chairman of the Panthers Party, also Dr. Sameer Kaul, National Spokesperson of the PDP, Mr. Sharifuddin Sharik, Lok Sabha MP of the National Conference, who joins us once again, and Sheikh Kayum, Senior Journalist and Analyst from Kashmir. Let me begin with you first, Mr. Sharik. You know, over the last 12 hours, NewsX has been able to speak to one of the eyewitnesses who has come out and made some startling revelations, including suggesting, in fact, that the cash trail leads right up to the door of the Chief of the National Conference, Mr. Farooq Abdullah. Now, given the fact that the patron of the party himself has been dragged into this mess, as also, of course, other serious charges have been made by this eyewitness, is it time for a CBI inquiry? Because several people are asking for a CBI inquiry. Why isn't the government of Jammu and Kashmir calling upon the central government to begin the process of a CBI inquiry? What's there to hide?
No, nothing is to hide. You ask this question to government of Jammu and Kashmir. You tell them why they are not agreeing or if they are agreeing. But I feel no problem. I feel no problem in CBI inquiry also. I feel no problem in CBI inquiry also, because we have to nothing to hide. This was the natural death of a person.
Well, several people...
And the witness you mentioned, he was PDP member for a long pretty time.
That's immaterial.
He was a PDP. Yes, yes.
That is immaterial right now. The fact is that an investigation will determine whose version is correct. That is immaterial, whether he was a member or he wasn't a member. That is for the authorities to decide, but which authorities?
This is why.
The question is...
Yes, I agree with you. I agree with you. There is nothing to hide. It is why Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir has ordered a judicial inquiry at the highest level.
The problem is
the Chief Justice of High Court.
Okay, Mr. Sharik.
To prepare a sitting judge for the inquiry. What is the problem?
Okay, Mr. Sharik, the problem is that people in the state of Jammu and Kashmir, all the opposition parties and people in civil society do not trust the government anymore after the revelations of the eyewitness Dr. Sameer Kaul. Do you, for instance, believe that this judicial commission
is going to get to the bottom of
this case?
Whom you call civil society? Whom you call? We are the civil society. I am representing people. My dear friend, tell me who is the civil society representative. I am representing civil society. I have won the election with thumping majority of votes.
Okay.
I am representing people.
You represent
it is not a handful of PDP.
Mr. Sharik, you represent
PDP
a section.
Degraded people.
No, Mr. Sharik, I represent.
Okay. That is true.
Okay, let me bring in Dr. Sameer Kaul. Let me bring in the representative of another party that represents the will of the people.
Winner of the election is the representative.
Okay, Mr. Sharifuddin Sharik, let me bring in the representative of another party that represents the will of the people, Dr. Sameer Kaul. Has the time come for an independent inquiry?
Yes, please.
Rahul,
no objection.
At the very outset, let me tell you that the party that I owe allegiance
to... We have no problem with that.
The People's Democratic Party, I'm proud of them for behaving like a responsible political party in this country. What they have done, they have highlighted about the roads, there being zero development. They have highlighted about moral corruption, political corruption.
Now ask me a very specific question.
The specific question is, there is no point in having any kind of inquiry.
Mr. Sameer Kaur, you talk to the point. I have no time. Talk to the point. They have ruined Kashmir. Mufti has got killed so many militants at that time who were ready to talk to Home Ministry.
Thank you, sir.
They have ruined Kashmir.
Is that a fact?
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Kaul, is that a fact?
My point is very simple. Our custodial deaths
spread across the board.
You may have any kind of commission, my friend. The question at the end of the day is, will it be
maximum
a fair one?
He's asking you a question. The PDP has been taking the moral high ground. The NC, Lok Sabha MP, is asking you a straightforward question that there have been custodial deaths also during the time of the PDP.
We are completely digressing here, my friend.
We're digressing.
All I'm saying is, let's keep to the point. And the point here is, you can have any kind of commission. You can have God alone come down.
Professor
but
Beamsi,
for God's sake, tell me, how can you have it with the government still being there?
And Mufti was home minister.
Abdul Salam Rashid tells you on the television that the IGP crime has told me to change my statement. How can you have it when everyone is there? Any kind of commission, but the government has to go.
So it is why we are
one minute, Mr. Sharik. One minute, please.
To the judicial inquiry of Abdul Rahim Rathir? More than one and a half years has passed.
Yes,
corruption
please.
Charges against him. Nobody knows what happened. There are embezzlement cases in the rural development. There is zero development. Education department, for God's sake.
What about the question?
The question here is totally different. Mr. Samir Kaur, I welcome this discussion. The discussion is very simple.
Okay, one second.
Still, listen me.
Okay.
Samir Kaur has never known the facts. It was Mufti's time when people were killed, when Kashmir
That's not the issue here.
Okay, one minute. Mr. Sharik, there are other panelists also.
Mr. Sharik, there are other panelists also.
They want to make a point. Professor Bhim Singh.
My point is very simple.
Please.
That there is a person, human being.
A Kashmiri, an activist, political activist,
who was invited to the house residence of the chief minister.
Yes.
And he comes at 10 p.m. with the vomiting blood, taken to the crime branch, and from there he never returned, he came dead. My question is that no FIR has been registered till today on the death of a human being, even if animal dies. Under 174 of Criminal Procedure Code.
Important point.
Number one. Number
two. Is there a cover up?
Number two. That why CBI?
Okay.
Because then next day, Director General Police, Home Secretary, and the Chief Minister, they gave press conferences and saying that the man died because of heart failure and something.
Yeah, now there are two versions, Professor Bhim Singh.
I'm supporting your CBI, but that means now today a police officer junior to the Director General Police, an administrator junior to the Home Secretary or anybody working in Jammu and Kashmir cannot hold independent inquiry. That's why CBI. And finally, we are talking of Judicial Commission. Chief Justice has rejected the offer. He said, I have no spare high court.
Mr. Sharik, there is a direct charge. There is a direct charge. Before I go across to Mr. Sheikh Kayum, there is a direct charge. The charge is that all these supposed procedures that actually follow after an incident have not been put in place. There is no FIR. Even the Judicial Commission, in fact, is in doubt because the procedure that is being followed perhaps is not to the textbook.
They have said no.
They have also said no, apparently, the Chief Justice.
So what are we talking about? When a judicial inquiry starts, investigation can start by the police, by the experts. That's why CBI.
Dr. Kaur, that's a very valid point.
Very important.
And this point is not just being made by the political figure, this is being made by the family. By the family of the deceased. This is a charge that is being also made by the family of the deceased. They have spoken to NewsX and they have said, they have come out and said that why is the police not registering our FIR?
Rahul, they should have done. Anyone listening to the witnesses at all, there is a live witness going on television telling you that I told the Chief Minister 2.5 months back that I paid money. What happened all those 2.5 months?
Okay.
Rahul, can I come in now?
Mr. Kayum, go ahead.
I have been hearing Mr. Kaur and Mr. Sharif Din Sharik. You see, I want to put your discussion in perspective. Here is Mr. Sharif Din Sharik. He has a chair to protect. And here is Mr. Sumir Kaur. He has a chair to seek. So this is not a simple matter of political expediency. The fact is that a person has died in custody of the police.
Mr. Kayum, one at a time, please. Mr. Kayum, go ahead.
Yes. So a person has died in police custody. Circumstances are very murky. An allegation has been raised that the person was summoned to the Chief Minister's residence, that he was questioned there. One witness, Mr. Abdul Salam Rishi, has said that this person was visibly unwell after he came out of the Chief Minister's residence. This is reason enough for the matter to be taken as very serious. But having said that, The Chief Minister has said that he wants the matter to be probed by a sitting judge of the Jammu and Kashmir High Court.
Yes.
I do not see how does the CBI probe take precedence over a sitting judge of the J&K High Court. Please let me complete. If a sitting judge of the J&K High Court is nominated,
you know, the High Court judge does not have an investigative agency.
Let me complete, sir. That is hypothetical.
The Chief Justice has said nothing. The murder case.
Sir, let me complete.
The High Court,
please, sir, let me complete.
Court of Appeal against
Mr. Bhim Singh, I have high respect for you. I have not interrupted you. I am coming to what you also want to say. I will come to that also.
Go ahead, Mr. Kayum.
If a sitting High Court judge is nominated, yes, it will be for the sitting High Court judge to decide what investigative agency does he want to take.
Mr. Kayum, let me draw your attention.
Can I ask Mr. Kayum one small question?
Please, go ahead.
Mr. Kayum, sir, please can you tell me what has happened to the various judicial commissions that have been going on for more than 1.5 years? Namely, what about Abdul Rahim Rathar?
Absolutely, what? All right.
You can do another one of those, actually.
No, please. So go ahead.
I want to answer your question by asking another question.
Mr. Sameer Kaur, please, one second. What happened to those inquiries? Mr. Kayum has asked a question.
Mr. Kayum was asked a question. He has a right to respond.
I am going to ask Mr. Kayum, go ahead.
Mr. Sharik, one minute. I am coming to you. Just hold your thoughts. Just hold your thoughts. Please bear with us. Mr. Kayum is making a point. Mr. Kayum, first go ahead.
Mr. Kohl has asked me a question. What happened to the various judicial probes that was ordered here in the past?
But I can also counter his question
by asking him what happened to the various CBI probes, CBI investigations that have happened in the past. Sir, you have to either trust an investigative agency or you have to dismiss it. If we cannot trust a sitting High Court judge, for God's sake, tell me who. Let's not digress from the point.
One minute.
Mr. Kayum, very humbly, sir, please tell me, how do you expect a fair probe?
Yes.
If on a day-to-day basis, even lowly police officers are ordering your eyewitnesses to change their accounts, under whose orders does
very
this happen?
Quickly answer no, that
it's
question.
A, it's for everyone. It's nothing question. To do with PDP or NC. Please believe me. How can you have
Mr. Kayum,
a fair
very
probe?
Quickly yeah, yeah, answer yeah, that yeah, question. Yeah, yeah.
Don't you think murder deserves a probe?
But
these things are also subject to investigation.
Mr. Kayum, I am coming back to you. Mr. Sharik, go ahead. I can wait.
I agree with Mr. Kayum. You will have to trust somebody in the country. This is the constitutional way of life here. You have to trust either High Court, Supreme Court, whatever it is.
The point
you will
is,
have to trust
let me
you.
Ask. Let me ask a question of the panel.
Those investigations which Mufti Muhammad Saeed appointed commissioners in.
Okay, one minute. Right. Let me just ask a question of the panel.
Yes.
It's a straight, direct question. Let me begin with you, Mr. Kayum. Mr. Kayum, it's a little odd
that the center
which makes many noises and demands CBI probes when Shaila Masood dies or is allegedly murdered in Madhya Pradesh, or when
Mr. Bhatt's
case, for instance, the center rushes in to secure his family, etc., etc. Why is the center so quiet this time? Let me just broaden the ambit of this discussion.
You see,
Mr. Kayum.
Rahul, I have been brought into this discussion as a Kashmir, as a small person who reports Kashmir and a one. And
that's all right. Just answer my question.
Situation.
We don't have
please
much time to so answer my question.
Please don't try to ask me a question which you should ask from the spokesman of the Government of India. Why does not the central government seek a CBI probe?
Okay. Professor Bheem Singh, answer that question since you want to.
Let me answer this question. Because Congress is a party, the coalition partner, because Umar Abdullah's government is running on the crutches of the Congress, because Congress have equal interest in Jammu and Kashmir, is for political reason that Congress is digesting
Kaul,
all
what's
happening
is,
in Dr. Jammu
Kaul,
and Kashmir.
The irony is, Dr. Kaul.
Mr. Bheem Singh has taken concessions from Mr. Bheem Singh has also sought concessions from Mufti government. He got his sister's son as minister and MLA.
Okay. Dr. Kaul, the irony is that even the PDP is known for Farooq Abdullah said today. Why is it that the PDP is singling the National Conference out and is not talking about the role of the Congress?
Can I answer this question for you?
Yeah, please.
It's unfortunate. I can expect two people in bed together. In this case, the National Conference and the Congress.
Okay.
But they have gotten to a stage where they have started wetting the bed together.
Okay.
So they are wetting the bed together.
The point is for all of Mr. Sharik's righteous indignation.
I agree with Dr.
Just
Farooq
a few Abdullah. Moments ago, in fact, just a few hours back, in fact, Omar Abdullah
yes,
tweeted.
Please.
Omar
you
Abdullah
allow me
tweeted.
To talk. You don't allow me to talk.
Omar Abdullah tweeted, sir, saying that this entire issue is a non-issue. It's a media creation.
Yes.
It's a media creation for TRPs.
Yes.
Can we trivialize a custody death or an alleged custody death?
Will you give me a second?
Yes. I'll come to you. Mr. Sharik, answer that question.
This question you put to Omar Abdullah.
No.
You are as much a member of the National Conference as is Omar Abdullah. Yes, I am member and responsible man.
Yeah.
Exactly, I am.
So in the capacity of a responsible member of the National Conference, I'm asking you, why is this issue being trivialized?
As a member of National Conference, as representative of National, I assure you and assure everybody in the country that this is a natural death which is not a question of National Conference. Whom we have always defeated,
that
who
is
have
not
no
known.
Credibility in Jammu and Kashmir.
You see, your
yes. not a political platform.
Your inference is based on
is
no
he,
fact because there is a judicial commission
minister
for another investigation that will have to go into
corruption
for that.
Yes, it is indeed tragic. Are we going to hear next that 180 young people who died last year were also natural deaths? There were murders, there were killings, there was corruption.
Sharik Sahab, I have a very small point. Is it not a truth that man was taken out at 10 p.m.? Is it not a truth that he was taken to police hospital? Is it not a truth that there is no FIR?
We're really running out of time.
No, what I'm saying,
make your point.
CBI inquiry.
This is why we are going for judicial inquiry.
It's quite clear. Mr. Kayum, very quickly, Mr. Kayum, your last thoughts, your closing thoughts.
With the change at the top.
I need to go one last time to Mr. Kayum. Mr. Kayum, your closing thoughts. Do you believe that Omar Abdullah has trivialized this entire issue by suggesting in his tweet that the media is only playing this story for TRP and gain, etc. What next? Very quickly, your closing thoughts.
I would not agree with Dr. Omar Abdullah that the media has trivialized the whole issue.
Okay.
It is an issue of concern, and I think it concerns us as much as it concerns Omar Abdullah himself.
That's the point.
But my point is, why are we cribbing about whether a CBI inquiry or a judicial probe by a high court judge? Why can't all of us cooperate with the probe? The Chief Minister has said he will appear before the committee.
Charity in this case must begin at home, and there are people who are coming out and suggesting that the government is not being charitable to the feelings, the emotions of a family of a deceased.
If yes. Rahul, last point. Look, gentlemen, we are obviously talking over each other. We are running out of points.
Okay, very quickly, Mr. Kaya.
Charity means, very quickly, Rahul.
If you think
Mr.
that Rahul. Charity means Umar Abdullah
yeah,
must sit down because he has been condemned in some
Mr.
media,
Rahul,
I am sorry to say,
yeah,
he like all of us.
Go ahead,
right
go ahead, Mr. Sharik. Your closing thoughts. We are closing this debate after you speak. Please go ahead.
Mr. Samir Kaul, you have no right to say he has been elected by people genuinely under constitution.
Okay, we just wanted a closing statement, not another question, not another accusation. Gentlemen, we've run out of time. Thank you indeed. We'll just have to agree to disagree on this one. Okay.
He's not at the mercy of
okay, Mr. Sharik. Okay, please. We have to agree to disagree. We're running out of time. Thank you, gentlemen. There is obvious great discord and difference over the demand of a CBI probe. Let's just hope that all of you stakeholders can work together and get to the bottom of this grave mystery. Thanks indeed, gentlemen. Thanks indeed. And coming up on the show in just...